you speak some German.
Ich mag kein Wein. Ich mag kein Bier.
This guy, it took that long because of him. He wanted to get the script right, and he wouldn't do it without getting the script right.
Yeah, you know, once you wait that long, you know, once you wait 17 years, it better be worth the wait. So I just desperately wanted to have a story that was worth going back to the franchise and not just going back just because we had made two other ones. And I finally got to the point that I felt like it was a story that was modern, but also captured the flavor and the essence of the Bad Boys, but also a story that needed to be told and wanted to be told in and of itself.
I think once we got on set and we seen each other again, the magic just came back. It was like riding a bike. Yeah. You know, we wanted to be there with each other to do this again, and it just worked.
Yeah, the second we we're back together, ran a couple scenes, talked a little bit, and it was like the chemistry's actually better than it was before. We've both lived a little bit, wiser. I like to think a little bit funnier, a little bit sharper in our abilities to perform. And I think that when audiences see this movie, I think the fans of the first movie will enjoy this equally or more, and it will also bring in new people into the magic of the Bad Boys.
Best moves I ever made. This is the man right here. Yeah.
Now, Martin had the first one, and it was a few months that he was looking around, and I got the call that Martin had a script that he was thinking about, and you know, when I came in, I sat down, I talked to him, and then I just begged him, please let me be in this movie with you.
When he's the straight man, I'm the funny man. When he's the funny man, I'm the straight man. So we just balance it out that way.
Yeah, and it's really, there, you know, very few people that you can find that kind of chemistry with. I've had the blessing in my career. I would say the two people I have the best chemistry with like that is Martin Lawrence and Tommy Lee Jones. So, you know, I've been really blessed to work with people of Martin's caliber that really understand that thing. But it's not a lot of people that can move like that in a scene.
Will's a family man, but I'm probably more closer to my character because I'm more in the family as well. So I would say I'm more like my character and spiritual. I'm very spiritual, so you know.
Yeah, no, Mike Lowry is all the way my alter ego. I ain't nothing like Mike Lowry. Mike Lowry is my deepest dreams of how I wish I were.
Well, I thought it was great because they brought affection to the set every day. They showed everybody the same love, and they knew how to talk to you. You know, it wasn't a lot of yelling and screaming and all that. It was just a lot of a good environment to be around.
Yeah, and they were like 9 or 10 years old when the first one came out. So they're coming from a place
of, I wasn't born then.
Yeah. They're coming from a place of deep admiration and a face of pure fans, you know, and that's a whole different energy when the story and the franchise touches a part of somebody like that. They just came to set every day on fire, and that is hard to beat that kind of energy coming in. That's one of those scenes where the second you fall into it, and you know, everybody doesn't know what we're talking about, but there's one of the funniest comedic scenes in the movie, and it's like when you set up the comedic premise, and that's the thing, when the premise is set perfectly, and more than anything, I think that's the skill set where we can pick each other's role in the scene, and you set the premise, and then once the premise is set, then you can just go forever and hours, there's always another joke, there's always another idea.
Sometimes it is, because he clowns, he loves a clown, he'll make you laugh, but I have a lot of fun with him, man. I just enjoy working with him.
I can't even think of somebody that started a movie 25 years ago and then, you know, a quarter of a century later can still be the stars of the movie and not be the bartender or the captain or something, you know. So it's like it feels it's a real blessing and an honor to still be able to be at the helm of this franchise this long after the inception.
Yes, it feels great. I'm just glad to be a part of it.
You just got to be careful with Martin in the morning. Martin needs some time to get started in the morning, you know? Martin and...
Meaning what, like 8 o'clock or 11 o'clock?
No, he just needs to start the day slow. And this is like the tone I always talk. I'm always right here. So I just had to find, it's like, you know, hey, Martin, good morning, man. How you doing? You good? You know, he's like, you just got to start the day slow. You start the day too loud, you know. I look over at Martin sometimes in the morning when I get going, and he'll just be like, he's just meditating in his chair. He's like, well, Will need to settle down.
And Will doesn't have Achilles. If he does, I don't know which one, what it is, because he's on all the time. And he loves it. He loves it. He gets up for it, and I love it.